Welcome to Ultra Health Tutorial. Today we discuss about amoeba, especially Amoeba histolytica. So first, amoeba are classified on the basis of intestinal amoeba and free living amoeba. In intestinal amoeba, these are present in the intestine. Most common is the Amoeba histolytica, which is a pathogenic one, and Amoeba dispar, Amoeba coli, Amoeba gingivalis, Hartmanni, Pollicki. These are non-pathogenic. And the other species in intestinal amoeba are Endolimax nana, Iodomoeba, Buschelli. And in free living amoeba, these causes the CNS infection. The common are the Naegleria fowleri, Acanthamoeba species, Balamuthia mandrellis, Sepnia diploidi. Amoeba histolytica, it causes the disease either amoebiasis or intestinal amoebiasis, and the second disease, it produces the amoebic liver disease when the liver is involved. And the Amoeba histolytica is the third most common cause of the parasitic death in the world. The first one is the malaria, and the second one is schistosomiasis, and the third one is Amoeba histolytica, intestinal amoebiasis or amoebic liver disease. It occurs in three morphological forms: trophozoite, precyst and cyst. You can remember the trophozoite, it is meaning of the trophos and oid. Trophos ka matlab hota hai ki actively feeding, growing phase. And cyst is a something dormant stage which occurs during unfavorable conditions whenever the food is scarce. So the trophozoite, it has the two component, cytoplasmic component, ectoplasm and endoplasm. The outer one is ectoplasm and inner condensed granular is endoplasm. It is motile by pseudopodia. Pseudopodia is a false foot, and it has a single nucleus and has the vacuoles, food vacuoles. It forms, before forming the cyst, it forms the precyst during unfavorable condition. In this, the cyst wall is secreted and the cytoplasm and nuclear material starts condensing and storing the food in the form of glycogen body. So trophozoite converts to precyst, then precyst converts to uninucleate cyst, because from the trophozoite there is single nucleus is coming on. So it has the uninucleate cyst consists of single nucleus, has true chromatoid bars and one central glycogen mass. That is the food storage. And the outer one is the thick cyst wall. From uninucleate cyst to binucleate cyst, the nucleus material starts dividing from 1 to 2. Hence it forms the binucleate cyst. Then again binucleate, these two nuclei further divide into two, forming the four nuclei quadrinucleate cyst. And this quadrinucleate cyst is the infective form for the man. So man gets infection of the Amoeba histolytica by ingestion of this quadrinucleate cyst, and this quadrinucleate cyst goes in the small intestine by either contaminated food and water. From cyst, the quadrinucleate trophozoite will come out, and this quadrinucleate trophozoite will further divide in four nuclei, will further divide into eight and will form the 8 daughter trophozoite. So single amoeba cyst, 1 cyst to 8 daughter trophozoite will be formed. These 8 trophozoite, when it reaches the large intestine, either during time they can form the ulcer, or either the patient may remain asymptomatic. These amoebic ulcers are generally flask shaped. And in colon, inside the lumen of colon, these trophozoites start forming the precyst. precyst, then it will form from trophozoite, precyst, then binucleate cyst, then quadrinucleate cyst, and these are passed into the feces. Sometimes there is an intestinal ulcers. As I said, the flask shaped ulcers are formed superficial to sometime deeper, and they may cause the rupture of the intestine and the release of the ulcer fluid goes into the peritoneum, into the circulatory system, and may go to the liver and forming the amoebic liver abscess. So the patient may be either asymptomatic, which is the majority of the cases, and it may cause the intestinal amoebiasis. In intestinal amoebiasis, there is a diarrhea, dysentery. In the dysentery is a passage of stool with blood and mucus, foul smelling, black colored diarrhea with mucus. Sometimes when the appendix is involved, it causes the amoebic appendicitis and amoeboma. When in the intestine, a tumorous growth starts forming at the site of infection, that is called amoeboma, resembling to the cancer. When the colon is extensively involved, fulminant colitis or amoebic megacolon may occur. Due to dilatation of colon, the patient may present with a pain abdomen, diarrhea, sometimes fever like features. Amoebic liver disease, the patient have a pain on the right side of abdomen. And these amoebic liver abscesses can be single or multiple also. In most of the cases it is a single, and so one should differentiate amoebic liver abscess from the basilary liver abscess in the bacterial liver abscess, which are most of the common type, they are the multiple. And the most common site affected in the amoebic liver abscess is the upper left quadrant. From these left upper quadrant, there is a small cavity like anchovy sauce abscess. Like you can see in the last picture, these granular abscesses are actually filled with the pus, anchovy sauce. In this, inside the abscess, you will not find either cyst or trophozoite. But if you find, if you take the biopsy specimen from outside the rim, the wall of the abscess wall, you will found the trophozoite, and there are no cyst in the tissue. These amoebic liver abscess, if they enlarge, may rupture. If there is a left-sided abscess, left hepatic abscess, it will rupture into lung, diaphragm. And if it's a right side, it may rupture into pericardium, peritoneum, stomach, intestine, and inferior vena cava. And it, when it goes to the inferior vena cava, may also go to by systemic circulation into the colon, then again intestinal amoebiasis may result. Sometimes the liver abscess may also rupture from the skin and it causes the skin ulceration. So how we do a diagnose? We can do either diagnose by stool specimen or liver pus microscopy, in which we can see the cyst and trophozoite, and we can also do the culture of amoeba. It is an easily grown parasite. In the serological test, we can detect the antigen and antibody against the Amoeba-I. And biopsy specimen from ulcer in intestinal at the site at in the biopsy, it is preferably to take the outer wall of the ulcer and the outer wall of the hepatic abscess, in which it is a positive finding. And the PCR can be done in ultrasound. Abscess is diagnostic. Treatment is metronidazole and tinidazole. Any of them can be given. Thank you. And if you have some query about any parasitology, these slides are generally for the medical students, and especially keeping in mind with the medical MBBS and BDS and BSc students. So if you have any query, you can ask in the comment section. And if you want me to prepare to cover some specific topic of your interest, you can ask also. Thank you. If you like this video and share to your friends, hope you may find it helpful.